You're watching E10 and it's time now to gulp down what we have in store for you in the blue mug. It's one of those rare theatre where you will see talented Bollywood actors on stage as well. We take a look at what the play is all about and then also catch E10's Radhika Bajaj chat with the cast of the blue mug.
When I was a kid, I had this new doll and I used to call her Gui, short for Gudiya, and I used to comb her every day and put oil in her head every day, and one day my dad came and plucked it out and threw it on the roof.
It's a cast to envy for any producer, but hey, they're not starring in a film together. Konkana Sen Sharma, Ranveer Shori, Vinay Pathak, Rajat Kapoor and Shiva Chadha star in a play called The Blue Mug. And watch out because the mug could be getting near you pretty soon.
Arey beta, baat to SP ban gaya. Baat to tera abhi bhi DSP hai.
The play is inspired from neurologist Oliver Sacks' book, The Man Who Mistook His Wife for a Hat. The book is a compilation of Sacks' true life tales of his experiences with patients suffering from neurological problems.
For me, it is very difficult. I have not done many adaptations. I have just translated scripts in the past. This is one of the few times I have adapted, but then I had the support of, because it's a devised piece, it's created by actors with me directing them. And when you have actors like Vinay and Ranveer and all, really, trust me, they can adapt anything into anything.
Interestingly, the play does not boast of any fancy costumes, props or even a bound script. Since the act is mainly about playing out one's own memory, the actors improvise with their acts and dialogues, which gives the play a fresh feel with each performance. The Blue Mug debuted in Bangalore in 2009 and will be travelling to various cities including Hyderabad, Pune and Delhi between February and April this year. We spoke with the cast of the play to find out if sharing one's real memories can be a difficult task.
Once we decided the play is about memories and we would like to portray it by playing out our own memories. So the process started by sharing things about us with each other. And I think with a different group of people, it won't have worked. Hmm. Or it would have been very superficial kind of memories, you know, the ones that you can share without any trauma. But with this group, because there was enough faith and trust in each other, we could actually go down deep within ourselves and bring out the darkest things, you know, that you hide from everybody.
Konkana, how has your experience been being on stage? Because you don't do theatre very often.
Well, I haven't done any plays in a while, but I used to a lot more. And I had heard a lot about The Blue Mug before, because they had a show in 2002 or 3 and then they revived it, and two of the actors earlier could not, for whatever reason, participate. So Munish and I have other latecomers. And it's been really fun and interesting. Luckily, we don't really, neither Ranveer or I, our bits are not such that we have to really share any deep dark secrets or anything, because we
But they did.
Just for fun.
Just to be, you know, part of the whole thing.
Monetarily, people who do films, how does theatre pay back? Because there are a lot of struggling actors or actors who eventually want to do films. They don't do theatre thinking that I'm going to earn peanuts. Do you think that notion is wrong?
No, it's right. You don't get paid anything. You think we're doing it for money? Obviously not. But I just like to say that it's, I mean, even though we enjoy the whole process a lot and we would never not do it, you know, because it's great fun. But I would like everybody to know that it's a very difficult thing. Don't try it at home. It's only for us. Leave it for us. We'll do a good job. Just come see it. And we don't get paid for this, so if you have a
but,
big
but
heart...
But most of us don't get paid for the films we do either.
Yeah. Really?
So, you know.
So, any kind of support, monetarily or otherwise, is most
is welcome.
Is there a lack, is there a dearth of good scripts, like it happens in Bollywood as well, but is there a lack of scripts with good localized content?
I think you're going somewhere else.
There is, right? Somebody agrees.
See, yes, even I do.
See, vis-a-vis this play, if you think that it's an adaptation of a book, I would like you to first see the play, because it's an original creation, and Oliver Sacks' thing is, you know, just a thing to...
Just a seed, a spark.
Just a seed.
In one character.
In one character.
Okay, but then we were talking about how there seems to be a dearth of good
localization.
How can one get over that?
Right. Why don't you write? Why don't you stop asking questions and write instead?
Have you ever thought about writing yourself?
Yes, I have. I've sat blankly in front of a computer screen for hours.
Okay.
For months.
And open other sites.
Yeah. But any of you...
Oops, guilty.
But it's true. Even for film, like you said, there's writing is a problem. We don't seem to have a tradition of good writing.
Rajit, if you had to give advice to a friend for one day, one evening, what would you recommend? Watch Run or come and watch The Blue Mark?
The Blue Mark.
Okay, Ranveer, there's a magazine which seems to have nominated you for the worst actor, supporting actor for Chandni Chowk to China. If you get to win that award, any thoughts on the acceptance speech?
Yeah, I'll put on the goatee and the hair again so that, you know, kind of keep some distance to it. But I'm not aware of this nomination.
It's a random.
Finally, I've been nominated for something somewhere. So, I'm grateful for it.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you. It doesn't matter if I win or no, I'm just happy to be nominated.
Konkana,
handsomely.
We know that you have this persona on screen, which is serious actor, but we also hear that you are quite the joker. Quite the joker at the few parties that you end up attending. So, if you were to do a stand-up comedy for one night in Mumbai, what's going to be your opening line?
I am shit scared. We've got to wrap now.
Good line. Thank you.
Coming up, we tell you how to suffer from the Oscar fever and how to bring home a virtual pet.